It's Fantasia. So the trailer for Growing Together has dropped, and this is basically The Sims 4's version of Generations, and it looks incredible. Before we get into it, we're gonna go ahead and do our notification shout out, and this one goes to Jackie. You're so sweet, I appreciate you, and oh my gosh, I'm so excited for this pack of what I've seen so far. Like, I already cannot wait, and it sucks that we have to wait until March. I also hope we're getting strollers too. I don't think we're going to, just from what I've seen, but you never know. So thank you so much for your comment. If you guys want a chance to be in a notification shout out, all you gotta do is comment down below. So I've already seen this trailer twice, but I want to go through it with you guys and like talk about it. So this isn't a reaction, we're just going to be talking, discussing. So if you guys haven't seen the trailer, definitely go ahead and go over to the Sims YouTube channel and watch it, because I'm going to be like pausing and talking since this is not a reaction. I'll probably like, I might also slow it down, I haven't decided yet, or I'm just going to pause, I don't know. But the Sims 4 Growing Together expansion pack, so let's go ahead and start this. Look, the kids are riding bikes, guys. We're finally getting bikes for the kiddos and cribs. I feel like and puzzles. I feel like the cribs were expected because of the infants, like that's coming with the base game update. Look, okay, movie theaters. I noticed that and I was like, oh my gosh. Okay, so we have slumber parties. There's so much going on. Like, I'm just gonna point out everything that I have noticed so far. Look, splash pads. We're getting water parks. Like, what? And this is actually something we can go with our Sims. Also, this whole living room. Okay, I'm gonna let it play through and then pause. But did you guys see that? Like, I'm assuming the infants can do tummy time. I actually think tummy time was shown as well. And look at this animation. The infant is on the back and then holding the child like that. And then blowing up balloons. The sleeping bags are so freaking cute. Changing tables. And the infant is peeing everywhere. Look, pulling out a tooth. So we got the hints for like the tooth fairy and all that. So yeah, kids can actually lose teeth. I really hope we actually have to put it. Oh, there was tummy time. Did you see that? Okay, I'm going a mile a minute. They're building a tree house. But I really hope we can put the teeth underneath the pillows. You know, that would be cute. But look, this tree house. And from what I've seen, there's different tree houses, because I did see a photo of another tree house. So that's cool. Baby showers. Baby showers. And then as we saw, look, that Sim had birthmarks. I already saw that on the toddlers. And look, we're like hiking. Oh my gosh. And the grandparents are coming to watch the infant while the parents like sleep and stuff. Look at this. Look at that. This is like a family gathering. How freaking cute. And we got like the whatever that's called, dominoes. Look at the infants playing. How adorable. Oh, and there's something at the end here. I think it's coming up. Look, it looks like it's being video recorded. So in The Sims 3 Generations, you can make home videos. See, it looks like a Sim is filming it. And then you can make like a home video and play it on the TV. I hope that's what that is. So then at the end here, if you pre-order, okay, so by the way, available March 16th. So the infant update is coming out March 14th. So guys, I don't know if I'm psychic or what, but I predicted this and then I got thrown off. And I thought we were gonna be getting infants like right at the start of the year. I got totally thrown off. But if you guys have been watching my videos for a while, you know that when I didn't even know infants were coming, when I predicted that better babies were gonna come to the game, like when we didn't know that we were going to get infants, all of that, I would predict that we're going to get like a better babies update and then a generations expansion pack. That's what I always said. That was back before like we even got hints and everything. And now that's exactly what's happening. Like, we're getting infants and then 2 days later, we're getting like a generations expansion pack. How do you guys feel about them calling it Growing Together? I like it. I wish it was just called Generations, to be honest, just because that's the classic. But Growing Together, I feel like it goes with like the Sims kind of theme that they go with The Sims 4, like we have get together. So I think it sounds good. But anyways, if you buy the pack by April 27th, you get these free items. So you will still get like a baby carrier, even if you don't buy it by then. There's like another one. This is just like, this one has like a hood over it, you know. The one that we'll be getting with the pack looks a little more simplified, I guess. But look at this new slide. And I love the swing set. So yeah, we're familiar with this. We're often getting like bonus content if you pre-order now for like a whole bunch of different packs. But let's go ahead and slow this down a little bit. I'm not going to slow it down too much because I feel like, you know, I've already watched this a couple times, so I definitely spotted a lot of things the first times around. These buildings back here, they're probably just rabbit holes, like not even rabbit holes, just shells, like nothing, just like decoration. But I would love if these were something. I just don't think they are. I mean, like, it would be cool even if like this was a restaurant that we can't go in and then our Sim can get food and then eat out here. That would even be cool to see. Also, the kids, Look at the helmets. I love the bikes for the kids. Like, I know we have bikes already for teens and adults. These bikes look cute. I love this. Like, pink and purple. And then little ladybug helmet. Look at this dress. I really like this dress. Also love these pants that the Sim's wearing. So I'm just gonna, like, you know, pause it when we see different clips if I want to, like, point out anything. Okay, so this infant's bedroom. So freaking cute. Okay, this hair, we're gonna see it more. I am obsessed with this hair for the infants. Like the onesie, I love the way the cribs look. Here's a change table. I love all this decor, like even this on the wall, like this, everything is so cute. Look at this little lamp and the unicorn. This looks like, you know, it was handmade, which is so freaking cute. Oh my goodness. See, this looks recorded too. Okay, hang on. I've just picked up on this. This looks like it's also being recorded. This could just be an effect for the trailer, but keep in mind, Generations in The Sims 3 had the option to, like, video record. Like toddlers walking for the first time, and like you get it on camera and then your Sim can put it into the TV and play it and they can like watch it back. So then it creates like really cute memories for your Sims. So I don't know if that's what's happening here, but this little infant is freaking adorable. So puzzles. Also guys, they're putting together a horse puzzle. Everyone is noticing all these hints for horses. And I'm just like, ooh, maybe we're getting horses in the future. There's been multiple things. I'm seeing stuff on Twitter and apparently the Sims team has been replying to people on TikTok with like a horse emoji or like the cowboy emoji. I don't know. I just saw that, like people saying that. I didn't see it myself. So definitely a lot of hints there. And that's really interesting. Oh, also I love her necklace and the shirt. So freaking cute. And she's missing a tooth. Okay. I love this. This looks like something that would be in school. Like for a second, I was like, oh my gosh, is this a daycare? But no, it's not. It's just a library. When I first saw it, like I saw this and I was like, oh my gosh, this is giving like daycare vibes. And the kids can like put their drawings up here, but no. I don't think we're getting that. I really want daycares. I mean, who knows? Maybe we will. I don't know. I just love everything. All the way the furniture looks. Like, all of these items just look so good to me. I'm just so excited. You can, like, sit with your grandparents and do a puzzle. How adorable. Like, I feel like that's the perfect thing. I also don't know if he has new skin details on. Do you guys see this? I really like that. It just looks, like, realistic. Okay, so I noticed this the first time I watched the trailer, even when it was going super quickly. I was like, oh my god, movie theaters! Because, again, if you guys have been watching my videos for a while, two things that I always talk about, like, even in, like, wish list videos that I make of things I want in The Sims 4, I'm always talking about movie theaters and grocery stores. We, like, kind of have groceries now, but we still don't have, like, a traditional grocery store. So I still want that. But, yeah, I've just been waiting for a movie theater. This is probably a rabbit hole, but that's how it's always been. So that doesn't bother me if it is. As long as our Sims like can get affected by it, like get moodless and stuff like that, then I'm okay with it being a rabbit hole. Obviously it'd be amazing if we can go in, but just based off how it looks here, I think it's basically gonna be like The Sims 3, where it's just a rabbit hole. So I mean, it's something, right? Okay, so then this clip, look at this desk first of all. Do you see this? There's a unicorn. I wonder, there's also been a lot of unicorns. There's been a lot of horses and unicorns in this trailer, and I'm just like, oh my gosh, are we also gonna get unicorns? Because that was in The Sims 3. Not in this pack. But we're getting, but you usually they will hint like future packs in trailers. Like, guys, do you know the Nifty Knitting trailer, or was it one of the screenshots? I did tons of videos about this back then. They hinted the Snowy Escape pack, and then they were hinting this pack. They had an infant like playing with a dog. It was like a memory. The grandma was on the rocking chair, and there was a memory above her head, and it was an infant with a dog. And I remember questioning that. I was like, oh my god, better babies. That was like way before we ever heard anything. So they be hinting packs like way ahead of time. So yeah, keep that in mind. I don't know, like if we're gonna get horses, it could be long from now. There's also like a lot of cars being shown, but they do that a lot, so I'm not gonna think anything. Also look at this bumblebee backpack, how freaking cute. So look at this here. Oh, and there's like nachos on the floor. Look, this is so cute. I'm so glad you can feed the infants like this. Okay, this is adorable. The toddlers and the infants are gonna have interactions. Like, oh my gosh, like siblings being so close from a young age. That's gonna be so cute. Look at this teddy bear. Like, fairies. Okay, see, I mean, I don't like to like point out, I'm never like this. I don't usually like, well, sometimes. Sometimes when something's obvious, I'll be like, oh my gosh, this is definitely a hint. But like things like this, I usually wouldn't point out. But like, because, you know, it's like, oh my gosh, you're reaching. Well, it actually seems like they've been hinting a lot lately. And the fact that the Nifty Knitting had a grandma in, like what I was just mentioning, the fact that they put a hint for that for the infants in the future, like, just leads me to believe they throw in hints everywhere, even when something's like way far off. So like, I wouldn't be surprised if this is a fairy hint. Like, you don't know, the Sims team does this. So I don't know. Okay, and then this, like, we are, like, it was confirmed, I'm gonna go to the little blog post after, it was confirmed that we are getting the water parks or like splash pads. And how freaking cute is that? That is adorable. I love it. I just love it. I love this. Like, oh, I'm so glad that we're getting this. This is adorable. More horses. Like, everything is horses. Also, is this just clutter? Because this is adorable. Like, there's like a sippy cup. There's like a little coloring book and everything. But yeah, hopefully they can. I saw tummy time, but hopefully they can do tummy time here because that would make a lot of sense. But like, I'm so glad this is going to be an object. Look at this table in the back. I really like the way that looks. Oh, how cute. And then, okay, so apparently they can learn to ride a bike. That's also in the blog post. And it looks like he's learning and the parents are watching, like, how perfect. That's something I've always wanted. I want the kids to be able to learn things, not just automatically know how. So this is perfect. Like, how cute. And I can't believe, like, this animation must have taken some time. Like, I would not expect this with the baby on the back and lifting the kid up. Oh, so precious. Blowing up balloons. Again, I love that. This whole setup. I love all the furniture. So, like, the parents can have slumber parties with the kids in the living room even. How adorable. Oh, also, infants are, like, having treats and everything. And toddlers are getting overhaul. They're getting more treats and stuff, which is so cool. So here he pulls out his tooth. I'm a little nervous. Because it almost looks like he gets money instantly. And I'm nervous that that's exactly how it's going to be. I want us to be able to put under the pillow. So let's hope. And then look at all this on the wall. Oh my goodness. See, tummy time. Okay, so I don't know like how many objects there's going to be for them to do tummy time. Because you can see the toddler like looks like they're on like a little mat. And then they're able to do tummy time. So look at this. Like the whole family putting the treehouse together. Oh, this is so cute. Oh my goodness. I love the way the treehouses look. Like there's even a slide and everything. Like it's actually a nice treehouse. It looks like you can do a lot of things in this treehouse and you can like, the whole family can come up there. It's probably going to be a new woohoo spot. Definitely they'll take advantage of that. Oh, these Sims are so adorable. Look how precious. Oh yeah, you can lose your jobs. So I guess he lost his job and like, you know, it's all messy over here because he's upset in the baby showers. I'm pretty sure it's confirmed. Like, I think I read that in the blog post. I will show you guys. But yeah, this is definitely a baby shower. All the hands are pointing towards it. I know nowadays people will have baby showers with men and women, but traditionally baby showers are usually just all girls. And so the fact that, you know, a Sim's pregnant here, they're giving gifts, there's balloons, and then it's all girls. This is 100% a baby shower. Like it has to be. Otherwise, I feel like they would have put like men in that clip. Also, this is really putting into perspective how much bigger the toddlers are. I think like you guys might think they look similar because sometimes it comes off that way, like in certain clips, but no, they're definitely like the perfect in-between size between like a newborn and a toddler. And I'm so happy. I feel like they did really well. I don't know. Just when I saw this toddler standing here, I was like, okay, they're like quite a bit bigger. And then look at the birthmarks. Like I love that. And there's board games and everything over here, like puzzles and all that. There's just so much toys everywhere. It's so cute, this desk and this on the stairs. And look, like they're hiking. So we did kind of get like hiking with Snowy Escape, but this looks different. I don't know, like this seems different to me, even the way they're walking. Look at this, like they're up in the middle of the night, the infant's crying. I love this. Also, I really like her little nightgown, adorable. And then the grandparents come and they have a suitcase. I don't know, like I hope this happens. Like I want the grandparents to come with a suitcase, like as if they're visiting from like further away and like gonna stay for a while, because that's so cute, like family coming to visit for like an actual duration of time. Like this living room looks so wholesome. But look, and then yeah, they're sleeping while they're cleaning up, she's taking care of the infant. Like it's just so perfect. Oh, look at them hugging. How freaking cute, right? And this looks like a whole like family barbecue. Everything just feels different, and I really hope that's how it is. And the dominoes. Oh, this toddler's freaking out in the back. See, like guys, they're perfect. Like look at the difference. I'm sorry, but like it just makes me really happy. Yeah. Look how much smaller they are. Oh my god. How cute. Aww. They're so freaking cute. Like, I love. Adorable. And I think they're showing each other photos. And yeah, this looks like a video is being recorded. Which, if that's the case, I'm gonna be so happy. Oh no. And there's baby wipes. This clip is so cute. It's like everything. Like, hello. Look at this little cutie patootie. Oh, get familiar. March 16th. Okay, guys. So the trailer looks incredible. Then I'm going to go through this with you guys. I'm not going to read everything, but I will link it down below. So Family Matters in The Sims 4 Growing Together Expansion Pack. Baby, proof your house. The Sims 4 frees the infants. So we just saw this clip and oh, she is so cute. I love the hair with the bow. Okay, so like I said, I'm not going to read all through this. I'm just going to point out certain parts and then I'll link this down below if you guys want to read it all the way through. But there's going to be some stories that are teachable moments. You can have a house full of drama. And yes, this pack, like, you know, everything about it is just family. Like, you know, there's gonna be family dynamics, family bonding, Sims grow up, beginning at the new infant life stage to grow old, hit new precious milestones within their families. Look how cute this photo is. I love the world, guys. I'm so excited for it. So there's gonna be a beautiful ocean bay, perfect for families, lots of outdoor open space for family gatherings and for children to play. It keeps talking about how there's gonna be so much to do, so I really hope that's the case. Let's cross our fingers. It does feel like this pack is gonna really change like the overall game instead of just like, you know, high school years, it's like only changing the high school experience. Then like, you know what I mean? I feel like we're really due for a pack that changes the whole game. And it does seem like that's gonna do this. Okay, so here we go. Learn to ride a bicycle. They can also walk in a group, jog, or even hike in a nature path along the Gilbert Gardens Lake. Play on the playground, take it slow, go fishing with the grandparents, watch a movie at the Wharf's refurbished theater, grab a bite to eat along the pier, visit the library with children's book, or even splish and splash at Whalebird's public splash pad play area. So I'm so excited for that. Like, I was not expecting that at all. Then we go into infant stuff. Now, we know we're getting infants for free, but there could be some stuff that's in the pack. So honestly, I don't know. Like, obviously this is in the blog post for the pack, so I don't know if it means like this type of stuff is going to be what's in the pack. If so, keep in mind the traits and stuff might be in the pack, but I feel like that would be weird. I think we're going to get the traits in base game, because that would just be super strange to me. So it does confirm here in this free base game update. So yes, we have official confirmation. So we're going to be able to edit them in CAS. We do know that. There's going to be a wide range of clothing, accessories, and hairstyles. You can also adopt an infant. Age up from a newborn to infant to a toddler. So of course you can do all the things with infants that you would expect, like change their diaper, give them a nap, all of that fun stuff. And then adding more depth and gameplay to the life stage, among other life stages, including toddler and children. So there's going to be a new infant milestones. These milestones both highlight the way your Sims are growing up. Caregivers will have new ways of playing and caring for their infants with the changing station and infant playmat, as well as be able to carry them on their backs. And then it says here, so let's celebrate our new infants with a baby shower event. So yes, it is confirmed, which is so freaking exciting. Okay, so they're adding 18 discoverable infant quirks that change an infant's behavior. With 3 quirks per infant, each infant is bound to be unique. Some quirks include self-soother, early rise, messy eater, frequently hiccups, gassy, good appetite, snuggly sleeper, happy spitter, free air tinkler, and more. So then they're more likely to just like pee all over you, which is so freaking funny. I love that they're actually going to be able to have quirks. Like, that is so freaking cute. So they keep talking about the base game update, so I'm sure this will be in the base game update, so I wouldn't worry about that. So I think there's also going to be another live stream on March 3rd, which is shortly before they release, so elders can enjoy a good power walk, a puzzle at the recreation center, or their role as a caretaker of the family keepsake box. They're the best at giving lessons, reminiscing on good times, and sneaking treats. Sometimes they even have a favorite grandchild. Speaking of grandchildren, toddlers are getting quite the update in this pack, guys. They're overhauling the toddlers with this pack. So we're going to be getting 18 discoverable toddler quirks that change a toddler's behavior. This is so perfect because I feel like toddlers are amazing, but they're lacking a little bit when it comes to personality. So some of these traits are going to be aggressive, picky eater, early riser, little singer, good appetite, loves water, hates bedtime, loves being carried, and more. So the children are also getting more attention, which is amazing because I feel like they're also lacking. For the first time, children have received 4 new aspirations. Slumber party animal, mind and body, playtime captain, and creative genius. Like, guys, it's about time. This is so good. So for the kids, we're getting a new treehouse, we're at the splash pad, bike, sleeping bag, slumber parties, friendship bracelets, and more. So yeah, this is so exciting, guys. Obviously, like I said, I'm not reading every little thing, so definitely go ahead and give this a read just for anything I'm not going over, but I just wanted to point out like the main stuff. So of course, like, the adults are going to be able to go through milestones as well, and they have to overcome things like a career obstacle, getting let go from a job, a midlife crisis, having the family move in, and so much more. So like, I guess, like, the grandparents came with suitcases. I wonder if they were moving in. So this expansion pack has a whole like family dynamics thing. So this is going to include new social compatibility feature, which introduces new ways of socializing that will feel different with each Sim, leading to deeper, more meaningful relationships with family and friends. Maybe specific family members are jokesters together, or maybe they are competitive. Your Sim's family tree will now reflect more complex family relationships. This is so good. We need this. We need Sims to act different with each other. So they're also going to have preferences that determine who they're socially compatible with and like who are their sworn enemies. That is so cool. So that is basically it. As you guys know, this pack is coming out March 16th. And if you pre-order, you know, ahead of time, or if you get the pack by April 27th, you will get, like, the bonus items. We have to wrap it up on this because how freaking cute are you? But you guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up here. Are you guys excited? I cannot wait. This is going to add so much for my existing Let's Plays, and then I might make a whole new family Let's Play because that is my favorite thing. My Seasons Let's Play was one of my favorite Let's Plays I ever did as far as, like, feeling wholesome and just having so much to do. So that's why, like, Seasons is one of my favorite expansion packs. I feel like it adds so much for family with the holidays and all that. And this, I feel like, is just going to tie everything together. Like, ugh. I feel like Seasons and Growing Together are going to be my two favorite packs. I wish it was coming out sooner, but you know what? At least we know when things are happening now. We were wondering for so long and now we know. So guys, I'm going to like have links down below to like the article and stuff if you'd like to read that in the trailer. But I hope you guys enjoyed this one and I hope you guys are all having an amazing, amazing day. And don't forget to leave some positivity down below. I love you guys also so much and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye guys!